thank you for having me here today. My name is Geert van Baasdorp, founder of Intelligence Group, and I will tell you a little bit more about what we do. Well, one of the main questions yesterday was, do we know what candidates expect? And do we know what candidates drives? And that's exactly the question that we research already for 15 years. We look at the supply side of the market. So we I think everybody here knows something about the demand side of the market. And we just pick the other side. We question and we research the supply side of the market. And we ask the workforce or the candidate, what are you looking for? Or what drives you? What kind of employer benefits are you looking for? How do you look for a job? What kind of hobbies do you have? All you want to know about a candidate, that's what we research. And we bring that kind of data to the market in demand supply portals. And we do that in 28 countries. And it's not going to be a pitch, but I want to show you what kind of information that is. That's information about the size of a target group, but also how many of the target group are active, changing their job, being hunted in the last quarter. So that says something about scarcity. What drives them? What are benefits, pull factors? And this is interesting. This is different for every target group in the market. And there are enormous differences between countries. So what drives an engineer in Belgium, a junior engineer, is different than a junior engineer in Germany, and especially when it goes to international mobility. And what I think will be the future of the data is not about what drives people, but what they expect in an application process. So I think candidate experience will be one of the main topics that will make you recruit better than anybody else. So questions as, what's important aspects in the application process, or important aspects on what kind of elements you want to negotiate. Now, one of the things we also ask about is, how do you look for a job when you are active or when you become active? So we look at the passive candidate, but we look at the active candidate. And I want to go in detail in three answers and three categories that have been answered. And that is, how many will use a job board when they are looking for a job? How many will upload their CV to any kind of website? And we go in further in what people answer, as in what kind of job boards would they use when looking for a job. So the kind of results I would like to share with you. So we did that in 28 countries. So that's too much to show you all, but I will give you an overview. We do that kind of research already since 2007, started with doing that together with the network and StepStone, but in the last years doing that independently, asking 60,000 people, 28 countries, doing that every 6 months. And because we are on the supply side of the market, we work together with companies like TechKernel for the demand side on the market, and that's why I'm also at this conference, because there's a lot of data that could be combined and gives extra insights to the market. So I will now throw over a lot of data. The good news is you get the presentation and also a white paper by the ending of this conference, so you can all look above it. But what I will show you is a couple of these slides with 28 countries in Europe. The more red it is, the color, the more people are using a job board or a CV, upload a CV. And what we see here is the uses of job boards by the European labor force. And 51% of the Lithuania workforce uses a job board when looking for a job, followed by Finland, Hungary, Romania. So we can look at the top, but what we did is also look at the bottom. So I saw Sweden and Estonia and Slovenia at the bottom. So when my research crew came up to me with these results, I said, no way this is correct. This cannot be correct, 90%. There's something wrong in the data. Well, it could be translation, could be anything. Could be in measurement, weighting the data, etc. But it wasn't. it's 90% that uses job boards, but the answer came when we were looking at the usage of uploading a resume to a CV databank. And if we then look at the results, you see Sweden at the fifth place, but you see Estonia at number one. So there's a definition question that could be with us in research, but could also be in how we look at the market. Do we look at a job board as a job board? Or do we also see a job board as a place, as a data bank where we can upload resumes? So this was one of the first interesting confrontations with this market data. And what is interesting, again, Estonia, Romania, Greece, Denmark, a lot of the countries that were low here are much higher on this spot. And there's something interesting I will tell you a little bit later what gives us an extra insight. What I don't understand is this one. Portugal, 1%. So if anybody has an answer for me, or Bulgaria, if it's not legally allowed to upload your CV in those countries or anything, but we don't know yet what gives this insight. Tell me, please.
If in Poland, the market leader is about 80%, in Bulgaria the market leader is 100%, so it's complete monopoly, and the guys just are not interested in building a CV database. I mean, they're monopoly.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. So a lot of mystery still has to be solved, but this was one mystery. Thank you very much for that. Also, like in Germany, where privacy is an issue, that's something that we know as neighbors. So there's interesting stuff in the data. So what we did is we took this one, this usage of job boards, usage of uploading a resume to a data bank, and we put it together. And that gives us a total view on how important job boards in combination with CV data banks are in Europe when looking for a job. That could be active or when people become active. So we see Romania, Lithuania, Hungary, Finland at the top, and big growth markets below Germany, Bulgaria, Poland, Czech Republic, and Slovenia. So there are markets where we can win market share. What we also looked at was how do millennials use job boards and those CV databanks? They are the next generation, how do they adopt this, I won't say traditional marketplace, but a marketplace that is already 20 years around. And what you see here is an index score. So the index of 75 means in Ukraine, millennials use 75% more than the average Ukrainian workforce job boards. So you could say that millennials in Ukraine, Sweden, Italy, Portugal, Poland are more likely to use job boards than an average workforce within that country. What's also interesting is where you see loss of market share in adoption of a job board. And that's in Denmark, Bulgaria, Norway, Austria, United Kingdom, Netherlands. And I don't know really the reason behind that was happening, but you can presume that it's because of the adoption of social media. And this generation is more acting on social media instead of job boards. Could be other reasons, but we don't know yet. But this is an interesting element. Also, like in Italy, that we have a lot of young people unemployed, so the adoption could also be high there, but that's not for Sweden. So there could be more reasons why this is shifting. One thing is for sure, there's no one European view on what's happening on the job board market. So what we also did was looking at how strong is the market leader in preferences in a certain country. So how do we research this? If somebody says, I'm using a job board when looking for a job, or I will upload my CV on a CV database. Then the next question is open. Which one do you use? And people could answer open 5. By average, they did 1.2, 1.3, not too much. And we all recoded that data within the intelligence group. So if you go to Bulgaria, the market leader is mentioned in 52% of all open questions. So that's a little bit comparable to what you just said. So then you could say the presence of the market leader in the open answers is very strong. In German and Italy, it's way lower. In Italy, it's only 15%. So the market leader was only mentioned in 1 out of 6 answers. So there's a market that is really diverse. And now I don't know if this is the most important, but several of you will love me now and several won't. But what were the job boards that were most mentioned by the workforce in a country? And you see that. You see all the names. This differs for every target group, for every experience group, for any occupational area within a country. So this is the average of the complete workforce within that country. And when you look at all those names from a perspective, the first thing I see is there's only 2 names that come twice. It's Indeed and Jobs. And all the others are different. So one conclusion could also be there's no one European market leader. In every country, we have a different market leader. One other interesting thing is that the word CV is very powerful. CV.ee, and we have CV.lv, and we have CV career somewhere, CV bankas. The word CV is very powerful. And when the word CV is in the URL, most likely the CV data bank in that country is also much stronger than a job board. So that was an interesting insight. What we also did is look at the top 3 most mentioned job boards and how much of market share those top 3 had. And then you see in Estonia, Bulgaria, Ukraine, the top 3 almost have the complete market. For if you want to enter that market, you probably only want to enter that market as a niche player. But when we go down, again, Italy, but also Belgium, Portugal, Germany, you will see that the top 3 most mentioned job boards, not even half of, almost half, half of the market. That means high competition and a completely other dynamic of the labor market. So there's a lot of, well, there's not one European labor market. So some first conclusions, there's no European market leader. And that's interesting because if you ask in Asia to companies and they want to recruit in Europe, who are they going to call? There's no one job board doing it for all European countries. No, it can even differ completely. We just looked only at the answers of LinkedIn. LinkedIn is in no of the 28 countries the most mentioned one. But LinkedIn is very different when it's about presence in Europe. I always say at the east border of the Netherlands, LinkedIn stops. So when you go into Germany, Eastern Europe, or the Central Europe, it's like almost white. So this is more likely to be the place where LinkedIn is strong, but never number one in the research we did. The European market is real diverse with opportunities and threats. Opportunities because you can still win Europe. On the other hand, in some local and some countries, the player there is so strong that access to that market is almost impossible. And there's a definition problem because we now have spoken about a job board market and a CV database market. But people, what is LinkedIn? Is it the social media? Is it the CV database? Is it the community? Is it a job board? what is the definition that we give in to give it? And most important, what kind of definition does the candidate give this channel? So it's getting more and more diverse, and also a challenge to research. So what is the image and brand of this, well, of the job boards in general, and where are we going to? So I don't have the answer for that, but and there's a positive effect in using the word CV in the URL. I fixed it in 15 minutes, almost 15 minutes. So if you want to connect to me or want some more extra details, please let me know. Or if any questions that I can answer, or maybe your colleagues can answer, this might be the moment.